Let's look inside a business and professional communication course to see how courses are organized in an online environment. Your course will most likely be organized into modules. Modules contain all the activities, assignments, and assessments that you'll be required to complete for that unit of study. Modules can be set up by week or by unit. Your professor will decide how he or she will organize the course modules. In this course, you can see the instructor has organized these modules by week. At first glance, you see all the items for the week. You may also be able to see all the modules for that course. However, this is not the case in all courses. Some instructors have requirements set up for you to complete before you can move on to a new module. For instance, you might have to contribute to a discussion, submit an assignment or biosig verification, or complete a quiz with a certain score before you can access the next module. Other instructors may hide or lock the module until a certain date. And further still, some instructors will lock you out of a module after the deadline or availability date expires. So be sure to keep up with the activities and assignment due dates laid out in the course schedule. Let's take a look at a module to get information about this week. The instructor begins with a unit overview. Here, he or she will outline what the objectives are for the unit, what activities and deliverables they would like you to complete, and how the items align with the student learning outcomes for the course. Use the next button at the bottom of the page to begin moving sequentially through the items in the module. The instructor starts out the module with an assigned reading from the textbook and slide highlighting the chapters covered. Make sure that you have read everything so you'll have all the information prior to attempting the assignments and assessments. The instructor then has set up a discussion question for the class. Here, you'll be required to post, most likely for a grade. This is how some instructors gauge your participation in an online course, so be sure to use proper netiquette and apply what you've learned to the conversation. The instructor then has a quiz set up for one of the unit's assessments. Make a note of the number of questions, time limit, and due date for each quiz or test. Not all quizzes are set up to have unlimited time and attempts, so be sure to take note of all this information before you go to take it. Finally, the instructors have students submit a draft of their informative speech for a grade prior to delivering them via a synchronous web session. After you've completed all the items in the module, the next one shown in the locker become available to you within a certain time frame outlined in the course syllabus. This next unit will contain content for a new topic which has similar types of activities, assignments, and assessments that align with the unit's objectives. This has been an example of how courses are organized in the online environment. If you have any questions about your online course content, the assignments or instructions in any particular module, make sure to contact your instructor early in the week for more information or clarification so you can complete all of the required activities and deliverables by their due dates.